A tank with a rectangular base and rectangular sides is open at the top. It is to be constructed so that its width is 4 meters and its volume is 36 cubic meters. If building the tank costs $10 per square meter for the base and $5 per square meter for the sides, what is the cost of the least expensive tank and what are its dimensions? So this one's a little tougher. It doesn't involve just numbers. It involves some geometry. So we have to bring in some information from geometry as well. We're told we have a tank with a rectangular base and rectangular sides. So that's just, you know, a box, a rectangular solid. So let's just sort of start with a drawing here. Let's build a rectangular box. All right, and I'm not the best artist, but hopefully it sort of makes sense. All right, let's see what we have now. And let's say it has length and width and height. All right, so what do we know about this? Well, what are we trying to optimize, right? Always think about what are we trying to optimize in this problem? What's the objective? What is the cost of the least expensive tank? Let's figure out how we can build a cost model. All right, so let's see, what do we know for the cost? Well, the costs are $10 per square meter for the base. Hey, and it's open at the top, right? So we don't need anything at the top. We're only worried about the base for the cost of the top and the bottom. So let's see. If it's $10 per square meter for the base, hey, that's an area. It's $10 per square meter. So we have to figure out the area of the base and multiply it by 10. So we'd have 10 times the area of the base. Well, the area of the base is the width times the length, since it's a rectangle. Okay, now the sides have a different cost. The sides are $5 per square meter. So let's see, we'd have $5 per square meter. And so let's think about the front and the back. The front and the back have the same dimensions, the width times the height. So I'd have $5, and then I'd have two, right? One for the front, one for the back, and the area of those is W times H. Similarly, for the left-hand side and the right-hand side, they're $5 per square meter times two times L times H. So my cost model has three variables. So we can't do the calculus on this. We've got to try and get this down to one variable. So now, again, this was my objective. What constraints are on the problem? Well, we're told that the width is 4 meters. And the volume is 36 cubic meters. Now, I know the volume, well, the volume of a rectangular solid is its length times its width times its height, and I know that that must be 36. So then, if W equals 4, then I have L times 4 times H is 36. So then L times H is 9, dividing both sides by 4. And so now what I can do is I can solve for either of these pieces. Let's just go ahead and I'll solve for L. So then L is equal to 9 over H. So now what I can do is I can take the fact that the width is 4 and the length is 9 over H, and I can use these, I can substitute them into the objective function. And I'll have that the objective function is just a function of h. So let's do that. So take my constraint, my objective function c, the cost, and so that would be 10 times w, which is 4, times l, which is 9 over h, plus 5, times 2. 5 times 2 is 10. Times W, which is 4, times H, which is H. plus 5 times 2 is 10 again, times L, which is 9 over H, times H. So now my cost model, my cost is a function of H, and is 360 over H plus 40H plus 90. There's the cost model, and now it's just a function of H, and we can use calculus to analyze it. So let's find the first derivative, C prime of H. Remembering that 360 over H is 360 H to the negative first, this becomes negative 360 over H squared plus 40, and then the derivative of the plus 90, that goes to zero. We are trying to find now any critical numbers. And I guess I should mention, let's think about this a little bit. Let's go back to our cost model, our C of H, and let's think about the domain of this function. If C is a function of H, we know that H must be positive, right? The height of this rectangular solid must be positive. So let's keep that in mind as we move to the next step. Alright, so we have C prime of H is negative 360 over H squared plus 40. Let's set that equal to 0. Alright, so then solving this equation, let's multiply through by H squared. So then negative 360 plus 40H squared is 0. Alright, so this is quadratic, but there's no H term, there's only the H squared term. So I can use the square root property to solve. 40h squared is 360. H squared is 9. H is then, using the square root property and remembering that h must be positive, h is then the positive square root of 9, so h equals 3. That's the only critical number on our domain. All right, let's use the I'm going to use the second derivative test here. I could use the first derivative test to check, but I'm going to use a second derivative test. So the second derivative of C with respect to H would be 720 over H cubed. And notice that that is positive for H positive. So that means, so then H equals 3, since it's a critical number, must be at a minimum. All right, so what are some conclusions? What is the cost of the least expensive tank? Well, the cost, so now find the cost if H equals 3. Well, that would be 360 over 3 plus 40 times 3 plus 90. So that would be 120 plus 120 plus 90. That would be $330. So that would be the least expensive tank would cost $330. What are the dimensions? Well, we know that the width is 4 meters. We now know that the height is 3 meters. And then the length is 9 divided by h. 9 divided by 3, that would also be 3 meters. So it ends up being 4 by 3 by 3.